Now, the attacks launched a 10-year war on terror, and while America has eliminated Osama bin Laden, we still face threats. Michelle Kingsfield continues our team coverage with a local university expert who sees victory over fear.
We all remember the vivid images of that fateful day, September 11th, 2001. The fear and sadness on the faces of millions. The worst terrorist attack on U.S. soil shook our sense of security.
But all these false reports were coming in.
Dr. Mark Ensilaco, a UD expert on terrorism and the Middle East, says we're now quite steady.
Al-Qaeda is staring in the face of strategic defeat. Bin Laden's dead. The number two was killed 10 days ago. By my count, that's the fourth Al-Qaeda number two operational commander we've killed. We captured a senior operational commander just last week.
The Department of Homeland Security will spend more than $56 billion this year. Nearly three-quarters of it will be on counterterrorism. Everything from more thorough airport screening to top secret intelligence.
The information's flowing, it's being analyzed in real time, and I don't want to give a sense of false security, but Al-Qaeda's been weakened. We're stronger in terms of our ability to detect and disrupt terrorist activities.
And that makes it extremely difficult for them to carry out large attacks like 9/11. 10 years later, it's the internet that's making it easier for individuals to act out, and the reason for an attack has also changed. And Ensilaco says it's no longer the Islamist terror threat.
The Arab Spring has nothing at all to do with the call for jihad. It's a call to do with for human rights and for liberty, a form of democracy. By and large, it's been peaceful protests, except in Libya, of course. At every level, Al-Qaeda is under attack.
As for further attacks in America, it's believed we'll perhaps see more frequent bombings or shootings, like the one at the military base in Fort Hood, Texas in 2009. 13 people were killed. But overall, America and Americans are strong.
9/11 is something we can look back at as a nation and then ask ourselves who we are as a nation. But Al-Qaeda can kill Americans, but it can't destroy America.
Michelle Kingsfield, 2 News on your side.
And of course, many of us are thinking about our own safety today. Our partners, the Dayton Business Journal, gauge the pulse of the community through this question: is America safer 10 years after 9/11? 43% say we are safer, 37% say we are not, and 20% just are not sure.